Pete here with SmallBusinessResourceCenter.com and the Small Business Resource Center YouTube channel. Just wanted to put out some really important information. So if you need help fixing your credit, smash a like button, hit the subscribe button. Don't forget about the notification bell and share this with a friend. The reason why I made this video is because a lot of people, whether you're in business or, you know, I deal with this because auto loans and real estate, you have credit issues and you need to fix them. So I'm going to show you how to fix most of people's credit issues for free. You can do it yourself. And I'm not really endorsing anything. This is not a paid endorsement, but I am showing you this website right here, creditkarma.com. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to explain that if you apply for an economic injury disaster loan, the EIDL, what you need to do to try to get that reconsidered, or what people would say corrected, so you can get your EIDL approved. So check it out. First of all, the one website I would recommend, I'm on right now, of course, you can see on the screen, creditkarma.com. The reason why I would recommend this website, in the past, I didn't think they were too good, to be quite honest with you, but now they've gotten much better. Basically, I used to recommend a free annual creditreport.com because of the fact that it was, I think, it was .org, it was a government site. But the problem is they actually got worse and Credit Karma got better. So that's why I'm recommending it. The annual credit report, once you logged in, got your credit report, let's just say if you wanted to fix something, you could fix it. Then it wouldn't let you access the site for a year. Then what happened is they actually reverted, and actually you would log in once, and then even if you tried to log in a second time, it didn't let you log in for another year. So Credit Karma offers a better solution, and keep in mind, this is not, this is not a paid promotion. I'm just recommending it because I've seen so many people use it and I've helped other people. But, you know, sign up for a free account. They give you a pretty good idea. It may not be 100% accurate of what your credit score is, but it's pretty good. They make their money by offering you credit cards and stuff like that. So I'm not saying to take it or not to take it. That's your own choice. But having too much credit is not good. Usually, if you have any cards, you always want to make sure the balance is 50% or less than the total amount of the card. I'm going to go into other videos on how to increase your credit score, by the way. But keep in mind what I just said. If you get any cards, try to keep the balance low and try to keep it 50% of whatever's on the card. So that's kind of one of the good things with Credit Karma. Now, when you log into the account, when you have one, the thing that you want to do is look at your delinquencies and derogatories. If for some reason you had a problem with a coronavirus recently, I would contact that creditor, explain the situation, and ask if they could remove the delinquency. You never know. They might say yes. They say no. Okay. But if you talk nice to people, there's always sometimes that they may do that. You can explain what happened, explain that you've always, you know, done a good job, and ask them to remove it. When it comes down to your credit and looking at things that have been bad in the past, what you really want to do is you want to dispute those. And here's the way to do this, and here is how you fix your credit for free. So you want to really pay attention here. Basically, let's just say you have an old medical collection, an old auto loan, anything. It's sitting there. First of all, if you want to remove it off your credit score and improve your credit score, could be 50 to 80 points in about 30 or 60 days. This can easily be done. What you really need to do is, if you owe anything on it, first of all, you have to have some cash or a credit card ready. But if you owe something on it, you can call the creditor and say, hi, you know, I noticed this was on my credit. I really want to take care of it. Ask them if they will settle for less. Doesn't matter if it's 50, 100, 200. If it's very old and delinquent, most of the times they will take a lower amount, no matter what it is. So let's just say if it's a $1,000 old medical bill or a credit card or whatever, they may say, okay, great. If you give us $500 right now, we'll remove it. Tell them that you want proof that it's paid. And then, of course, pay it. If you have cash, great. If you have another credit card to use, if you have one now, great. Pay it right away. And then it shows off as paid. Sometimes actually your credit score might go down when something like that happens, but at least it shows it's paid. And if it was already paid, now you're at this step. Then what you do is you can go into your credit and you dispute it. Keep in mind, if it's not paid, you can't really dispute it. Sometimes you can for a very short amount of time, and I'll explain how. So you dispute it and you can put something like, please verify this account. Please verify this account means you're not sure if it's your account. You think it might be someone else's and they got screwed up. And the reason why you want to do that is because this is what happens on the back end of a credit company. They're dealing with so much crap, excuse me, that they basically are worried about collecting money from people. Now they're trying to collect all this money from people. Now they get a letter from the credit bureau saying, we're not sure if this account is owned by Steve Smith or whatever. And they get the letter, they notice it's paid off, and there's no incentive for them to take the time to write up a letter, get the proof that you owe the money, and then submit it back to the credit bureau. But that's what they're supposed to do. If they do not do that, that paid off derogatory account gets removed off your credit score in 30 days. So most of the times they don't respond. So let's just say if you pay it off today, in 30 days approximately, that shows that you paid off on your credit report. Now you file the dispute like I told you to. In approximately 30 to 45 days, that shows it disappears off your credit card, like credit report, like it was never there. Now everything else that's good shows up. And you could do this with past due credit cards that are bad if you're not using them anymore. If they're active, of course, you can't do it. You can do it with past medical bills, collections, auto loans, anything. And keep in mind, you want to remove these derogatories off your credit report so that makes your other good credit look better. A lot of times I've had scenarios where people said they couldn't buy anything. I showed them how to do this, or I usually help people do it. And then boom, now 45 to 60 days later, sometimes 90, you know, you're getting approved for a house or an auto loan, or you can get a credit card. Okay, now I'm going to go over the EIDL. So if you don't need help with credit issues with the economic injury disaster loan, just smash a like button, subscribe if you're not subscribed, and share this with a friend. But if you do need help with the economic disaster loan and you got turned down, these are the steps that you want to take. First of all, if your credit was good before you had problems with the coronavirus, you can get a credit history and save that information and then file your reconsideration. I do have information on the reconsideration, but basically you have proof, you file your reconsideration and you say, hey, my credit was good before the coronavirus and now I'm back on track. So, you know, I'd like you to approve my EIDL loan, and that's worked for some people. The other thing you can do is you can fix your credit like I mentioned to you. Hopefully you're back on track now, and you actually have 6 months to file a reconsideration. So if you missed a payment or something, hopefully, you know, if you talk to your creditor, make up the payment and ask them to, first of all, take the late payment off your credit score. Sometimes they will do it. And other times, if it's something derogatory you need to fix it. And then now you can apply for your EIDL loan and you should be able to get approved. So those are the couple things that you can do as far as the EIDL and applying for reconsideration to get your EIDL loan. If you have other questions on that or a different credit issue concerning the EIDL or fixing your credit, comment below, let me know if this helped you. Smash the like button and subscribe if you're not a subscriber. Consider that. Share this with friends and have a great day. It's Pete with the SmallBusinessResourceCenter.com.